working it all for us. Doing it all for love.
What's up, YouTube? It's your boy Darion, back with another YouTube video. Now I'm gonna react to Selena Quintanilla documentary. I don't know if I should react to this before the movie, but I think I should. I hope this don't like spoil you too much. I might just skip over it if they say something too crazy, but I mean, what more can I do? I need to get some water real quick first, because this is going to be a long video, so I gotta, you know, get comfy. Without further ado, let's go. I don't even know what to expect from this. As a female, I want to just wait for you to be sleeping.
You know, if you have a dream, don't let anybody take it away. And you always believe that the impossible is always possible.
Facts. Oh. Get it, girl.
Tejano music was on the verge of becoming a mainstream star. She broke records and topped charts with her number one hit.
Yes, Selena.
She's the woman who gave voice to a musical movement.
I reacted to some of these.
Her crossover English album, Dreaming of You, was in the works. She was a dancer.
She surely was.
A singer.
Definitely that.
An entertainer.
Definitely that. But she entertained everybody.
A Grammy winner. A fashion designer. And an entrepreneur.
She did it all.
She was a wife.
She did it all.
A daughter, a sister, and a dreamer.
A wife?
A combination of talent, personality, and perfection.
There's also going to be a perfume that's going to be coming out, the Selena perfume, and it's going to smell like chorizo and huevos.
I didn't know she was married. I thought it was her fiance at most. How did she say it?
Her name was Selena.
Oh. I thought her Selena.
Though her life was tragically cut short, she accomplished countless milestones throughout her 23 years on Earth that paved way not only for other Latina artists that followed, but for anyone with a dream.
It's the age for me. 23 ain't nothing.
Selena Quintanilla was born April 16, 1971, in Lake Jackson, Texas.
Oh.
She was Abraham and Marcella Quintanilla's youngest child, born after her brother A.B. and sister Suzette. Years before he was married, Selena's father, Abraham, was part of a Tejano musical group called Los Dinos.
Los Dinos, got it.
Is a musical fusion of both American and Mexican styled music. At 6 years old, Selena not only knew how to sing in English, but also learned how to sing in Spanish phonetically. Named after his old band, the new Quintanilla family was called Selena y Los Dinos. The band started playing at the family's restaurant. However, things changed once the recession of 1982 hit. The family was forced to close their restaurant and move back to Abraham's hometown of Corpus Christi, Texas.
Everything happened for a reason.
Only source of income.
Tell me also how
Corpus Christi, Texas. Music became their only source of income.
Tell me also
everything happened for a reason.
Who you are and why you like to play in the band.
I'm look at it now. And the reason I like to play in the band, good money.
Oh, really? You make pretty good money in there.
Yes.
I saw an interview. She said she's too honest for her own good. And she
is. Fairs, school auditoriums, and even weddings.
What you gotta do, sis?
By the early 90s, Selena's family started receiving recognition.
I see the ad.
This message is for men who hope to live to age 120. If that's not you, please skip this ad now. My name's Matt Cook, and I spent the last 25 years.
I love to jump around like that.
Because of this, Selena enrolled in a homeschool program. After shows, Selena would use her tour bus as her classroom. She finished her high school diploma on the road through correspondence courses.
I'm not with the online school stuff. I'm not with it. I don't know how she did it. By choice.
As Selena y Los Dinos gained popularity, they began to travel outside of Texas. They frequently performed in Mexico. Despite her heritage, Selena only spoke in English. She eventually, however, had to learn the language to interact with her fans and the press. Her language barrier wasn't the only wall that she had to break down. Selena was a woman in a male-dominated business. Many Mexicans felt as though she was whitewashed. Many American producers underestimated her because of her heritage. Others didn't believe that a girl should be performing Tejano music.
I know nothing about like Hispanic culture apparently, because I didn't know that one man primarily sang Tejano music. I didn't even know what Tejano music was until now, which I still barely know. And then what was the other thing? Oh yeah, they said she was whitewashed. I didn't know Mexicans and like Hispanics use that term.
Like my father was told that we would never make it.
She don't seem whitewashed to me. I don't know enough about her.
Problemas de presentaciones, porque hay muchos hombres que no piensan que la mujer puede agarrar a la gente o al público así como en un hombre. Pero wrong.
Very wrong.
She paved way for other women.
I don't see how a man is any more entertaining than a woman. I see them equally, like, either you're good at your job or you're not, you know? I like this video. She's like in the middle of everybody.
The family felt that they were stuck somewhere in the middle, neither fully accepted by Mexicans or Americans. This unique cultural perspective allowed for Selena y Los Dinos to form a special bond with
everybody
other unrepresented people
you.
Who also felt forgotten.
Yeah, some people just not going to accept you.
Selena y Los Dinos was modernizing Tejano music.
And it's like,
the genre that was once the old music of her Chicana heritage quickly transformed to the fresh and funky new sound created by Selena and her band.
And if they don't like the sound of her new modern Tejano music, then just listen to the old Tejano music. Like, she's not ruining the genre, she's just doing it her way. And if you don't like it, it doesn't matter.
Selena Quintanilla!
Hey.
Selena Quintanilla!
Yes!
In 1986, at the Tejano Music Awards, Selena won Best Female Vocalist.
As she should.
An award that she would win every year through, Selena is the only Latin and female artist to ever place 5 consecutive albums in Billboard's 200 top-selling albums in the U.S. and U.K. An accomplishment only made by Elvis,
consecutive?
The Beatles, and Garth Brooks.
Song fans, thank you for making this possible. Thank you.
Selena.
Selena. I like the difference in how like people with an American accent and people with the like Hispanic accent in some kind of way say like Selena, and like I can't say how they say it, but how we say Selena, but they say it a little different.
My parents, I love you so much.
I don't know what to say anymore.
This is so cool.
Selena was the first Tejano artist to ever win a Grammy.
I had this
really
knot in my stomach. I was so nervous.
Selena was nominated for another Grammy in 1995. Selena's album was the first Tejano album to ever be gold. Despite her enormous success, she remained humble.
It's an honor, totally. I was just happy to be nominated and to appear on All the Stars. I was doing my camera trying to take pictures.
The awards caught the eyes of famous music labels.
She is too nice.
Selena Quintanilla signed with Capitol Records. She thanked her fans for all her success and continued to be helpful and connected to her community. She spent her time giving back with various charity events.
She plays sports? I'm scared of this. What am I going to hit with the ball? She is bold.
Selena loved going to public middle schools and high schools.
What if I hit somebody else with the ball?
The importance of staying in school, pursuing their goals, and avoiding drugs. Schools to talk to kids about the importance of staying in school.
That's nice.
Pursuing their goals, and avoiding drugs, alcohol.
Girl, I can imagine some of the celebrities I look up to coming to my school talking to me about stuff.
You're not a follower. Gangs are only for followers. And you have to be strong-minded.
Music is not a very stable business. You know, it comes and it goes, and so does money. But your education stays with you for the rest of your life.
She even made a stay-in-school video program that highlighted Tejano music history.
And no matter what happens in the future, no one can take away my education. It gives me the power and
that's
the confidence
facts
to know that I can always contribute to my family and my community.
I believe in education. I just don't like the way school do it nowadays. Because now school does it just to force you to graduate. They don't really care about your education.
It was important to Selena to be a good role model.
So, I don't mess with school, but I mess with education. Well, I educate myself.
It was important to Selena to be a good role model for young women and people of color.
Yes. Because people of color got to stick together, y'all. I mean, I love people who are not of color, too, but...
So you can only imagine how much her dad freaked out when the new bad boy guitar player, Chris Perez, came into the group.
Oh. I heard Chris was her fiancé, girl. I thought she was going to say how he freaked out when she got...
The new American style, like he added. The group created one of Selena's most famous songs, Bitty Bitty Bum Bum.
Tomo freaked out when he came to the group. He joined the group, he said, I don't know, Selena looking good.
The group continues to tour, and the next thing you know, something starts to form between Chris and Selena.
Oh, is it love?
After dating in secret for 3 years because of Mr. Quintanilla's disapproval, the couple decided to take the risk and elope.
As they should, because, wait, she said...
And I like to thank my husband.
Okay, yeah.
I love you.
Oh, yeah, I understand, husband. I've seen this. Okay.
Abraham.
I gotta do the next parts, y'all. My bad. I forgot to do the next parts.
Abraham ended up accepting them into the family.
I gotta cut.
One word.
I'm sure he will end up accepting it.
Newlyweds got a house, a Porsche.
Got in the montage now.
Five dogs and a pet python.
Five dogs and a pet python. How in the world do they have the time to do this?
They were looking forward to starting a family together and spending the rest of their lives beside one another.
Where are they getting all this time from? Nah, but this goes. This is goes. This is cute. I don't even use the word goes because nobody relationship is perfect, but that's cute. Just cute. I said that so fast, y'all. My bad. She like Beyonce right here. I don't know why. Like baby Beyonce. Like Destiny Child days. Okay, giving us very much formal. Oh, she had like her own boutique.
Off the charts and fulfill her dreams. After years of designing her own stage costumes,
and I like,
Selena opened up her very own boutique and salon.
Well, in a salon. I appreciate this because she actually likes design and clothes. I can tell she loves fashion. But a lot of people do this just to get money off people that support them very quickly, and I don't like that. If you're going to make merch, and if you're going to sell your clothes in any kind of way, or sell anything, it has to be the quality, it has to be the quality that you want to buy. Like, you can't make a t-shirt that just say, Selena, in a small little corner, and be like, $50. No!
I decided that it was time for Selena to start her first English album in the mainstream market.
First English album.
Selena Quintanilla Perez went from performing in her parents' restaurant. Performing covers of Michael Jackson.
Hey, I reacted to this if y'all want to check this out.
How you doing, Houston, Texas?
To eventually beating Michael Jackson's attendance record at the Houston Astrodome.
Bruh, she did not come to play. This is February 26th. This is 25 days after my birthday, even though I wasn't born yet. Michael Jackson's record, but that ain't no game. That ain't no game to play with. Yes, yeah, she is just. What is that? I know it's only me.
Strongly support that these beings are not closely related to.
Yes.
Grammy award-winning music star Selena has been shot and killed in Texas. The 23-year-old Mexican-American singer died at a Corpus Christi hospital after being shot this afternoon at a Days Inn motel.
Corpus Christi, Selena.
Tejano music star, Selena.
Dead at the age of 23.
The suspect in the shooting has been holding police at bay for hours.
One of the biggest stars in Tejano music. She was shot twice in the back.
The accused murderer is Yolanda Saldivar, a friend and founder of Selena's fan club.
Saldivar had been accused of embezzling funds. Selena apparently went to the hotel to fire her.
Never in the history of Corpus Christi has someone's death had this much impact.
Friday, March 31st, 1995.
Selena Quintanilla Perez is dead.
Please don't say that like that.
Selena revolutionized what it meant to be a Mexican American.
Right, the American dream. I know. And all that. I don't know if I want to see this. This is obviously from the movie. Oh, she has her own makeup brand? Not brand. I know MAC, but like her own line, I should say. Her own line. Makeup line. I'm sorry, what is this? What was that? I was so lost on that one. Was this just like modeling?
Selena said, "The goal isn't to live forever, but to create something that will."
To see the impact that she had on everybody is just incredible.
She's shattering records. She's still charting, man. 23 years later.
23 years after her death, Selena Quintanilla Perez's legacy continues to inspire and fulfill the dreams that she once had for
she
herself.
She had a star on the Hollywood Walk of Fame. Yeah, what's the thing to make people cry? They're trying to make me cry. They're trying to play all the sad music for her.
want? How do you want to be remembered?
As not only as an entertainer, but as a person who cared a lot. And I gave the best that I could. And I tried to be the best role model
I feel like
that I possibly could. And
that's
the best
what I
want to
do. I
want to
be a great role model. I want to entertain y'all, but I want to leave an impact on people.
To me, Selena is an icon.
I think of the impact she had on the lives of young girls.
Selena means so much to me. Ever since I was little, I wanted to be like her.
My very first memory of her was me singing Como la Flor.
I wanted to wear bustiers.
I would perform pretending to be Selena.
With like all the sparkles and stuff. I even wanted to wear red lipstick.
I've always grown up listening to Selena's music.
I feel like she's impacted the Latino Chicanos.
But I'm a Morenita woman, right? I'm dark. I have black hair. My representation of a woman that looked like me was Selena.
She was a great role model to many people.
She would want kids to stay in school.
She wasn't in it for the money or the fame.
She was very giving. She was very humble.
She was very empowering.
She's an icon for Mexicans. She's an icon for women.
The Beyonce of our time, right? Of our culture. She's our Beyonce.
She's a good representative.
Yeah, and I was kind of thinking like the Beyonce of the Hispanics. Not to separate anybody by races, but yeah.
The Mexican-American people.
We work so hard to assimilate.
And she wasn't the type to fit in like most kids are.
Yeah, girl,
I was
she
one of the
classes of
kids who hated speaking Spanish. We're embarrassed to speak Spanish. You're never Mexican.
Whoa, really?
Kids who hated speaking Spanish.
Type to fit in like most kids are.
I was going to classes with kids who hated speaking Spanish.
Oh, wow.
We're embarrassed to speak Spanish. You're never Mexican enough for the Mexicans. And you're never American enough for the Americans.
She showed Americans, this is Mexico, this is Mexicans, this is what it's like. But she also showed Mexicans, I live in the United States, I can sing in English too.
She was so proud of her culture.
Many people thought that she wasn't good enough.
She took on an industry that wasn't made for women and she killed the game.
Girl, you proved them wrong. Like, we're so proud of you.
She just motivates me to not care what other people say about me.
She always said, the impossible is always possible.
It makes me feel like if I have a goal and I really try my hardest, I can achieve that goal.
I actually went to the Walk of Fame when she got her star.
I may not be a musician, but I too am an artist like Selena. Although she has passed, her legacy lives on through her music.
She's somebody-
all artists equal. All artists equal. Whether it's cooking or drawing, you know, just because people can convey art, love, and all that in so many different ways. So being an artist is not just singing, not just dancing, not just cooking. It's like all of it.
Y'all always look up to you.
I think she would have been really, really good if she was still alive.
We love you like if you're still here.
Her legacy has lived on to this day in the lives of so many other girls.
I know she's looking down on all these little Mexican girls wishing us the best.
I know that she watches us from above and I know that she would have been proud of herself too.
She is and will always be the representation of what it means to be a Mexican American.
I pray for her and I love her.
A perfect way to end it. Is that what? Oh, I smile. Oh, that's a lot of edits. Oh, gosh. Girl, you better have got your coin for this video. Taking it all for us. Doing it all.